Wir haben unser Panel jetzt hier sitzen, unser Panel von Experts, jeweils mit den Namen zum Wiedererkennen. Ganz unterschiedliche Provenienz, ganz unterschiedliche, nicht nur von den Ländern her, sondern von den Dingen her. Und wir haben eine Zahl von oder einen Teil von Themenpunkten, die wir besprechen wollen, die sich aus den Vorträgen und aus der Problematik der Diskussion insgesamt ergeben. Und zwar der erste Punkt soll sein, die Mechanismen der individuellen Vitamin D-Sensitivität. So the question is, what are the mechanisms of individual Vitamin D-Sensitivity? We have heard of genetics, epigenetics mechanism. We have heard some cell cultures. We have heard some human trials. And the question is, are we able to get this information of individual vitamin D sensitivity from our patient who's just sitting in front of us? So I would like to ask first for the callback. Is it possible to send you a patient, that is the microphone, to send you a patient and you tell us whether he has a poor vitamin D sensitivity? Is it possible in your lab?
In principle, it's possible, but normally you'd need an ethical approval to do this. So I mean, because you have to have deduced something, person, I need two samples. And you would have, for example, given this person a high dose of vitamin D, which, at least in Finland, needs ethical approval.
Needs an ethical approval?
So I just...
For the genetic.
No, for doing this type of intervention.
How much vitamin D do you give?
So I mean, what I mean is that just to go for the individual, just somebody says, I have some samples, doesn't help from my point of view. We need cohorts of people, for example, MS patients, or people having whatever common disease, or just saying healthy Germans, or healthy people from the Netherlands, or from Brazil, just take any cohort and do similar type of investigation we did. But we would need ethical approval for that.
Okay, but that means you are not already so experienced to say, I have an individual result and I can judge it.
Because yes, the functional... Say, in principle, I could do it, but it is not, we are not doing a service lab on that level that okay. We say, I mean, we all don't have a company or whatever. Yeah, in principle, we could do it. So technically, it's feasible. Okay. But if you come to the question, now 10 people want to send me samples, and I say, on one side, it costs money, yeah, and at the moment, it is not really money efficient. It's not a cheap test as if we would do it right now. And secondly, I would rather prefer to do it as a study, yeah, rather than as a service. Okay. I mean, we are in scientific lab, so we are not a service lab.
Okay. Yeah? And do you have any idea about the cost if we would do a study for 100 patients, 200 patients, what are the costs for the individual patient?
I would say 200 euros.
200 euros. Okay, an MRI is the same amount of money, so that's not a problem.